Treatment is not always needed for patients who are diagnosed with a liver tumor. It depends on the etiology of the liver tumor, whether or not the tumor represents something that is benign or not cancerous, or malignant or a cancerous lesion. So for benign lesions, you don't always need therapy. For different types of tumors, we have a variety of different treatments, both medical and surgical. So on the medical side, we have numerous medications which can be used for different types of therapy. Additionally, there are some liver tumors which are sometimes caused by medications and can be helped by withdrawing some medications that a patient is on. From a surgical standpoint, there are some tumors which need to be removed with an operation. And for that, at Johns Hopkins, we offer a wide variety of approaches to that type of disease. There's a wide variety of state-of-the-art treatments that we use, many of which are on the surgical side. For surgeries, we not only do the traditional old-fashioned large operations through big incisions, but we're also starting to approach these larger tumors through minimally invasive operations, where we make small holes in the skin and work with the help of cameras and long, skinny instruments. For tumors that cannot be approached with a surgical procedure, we'll often use therapies that utilize technologies like ablation or arterially directed catheter therapies. Minimally invasive surgery for liver tumors is not only an option, but it's oftentimes preferred here at Johns Hopkins. We do these two ways primarily. One is with the laparoscope, or the use of a small camera and small instruments. And the second is robotically aided, where we actually use a robot to help perform the operations. In both these cases, we use small incisions in multiple areas of the abdomen to extract larger tumors. And then secondarily, we're also working on shortening our patients' length of stays after these operations. There are many benefits from minimally invasive surgery. Many of those benefits actually stem from two core principles. The first is that minimally invasive surgery often causes less pain and discomfort. This means that patients are up and walking around sooner after their operation, they're eating better sooner after their operation, and they're doing things that we do every day, taking big deep breaths and preventing pneumonias after their surgery, all from less pain. The second correlate is that patients go home earlier. So they're with less discomfort, they're able to recover quicker and get back to a normal life in a more efficient way.